jazz and Kansas City's contribution to the evolution of the music, and what we're attempting to do here at this fine institution to preserve that legacy. As parched lips kiss warped reeds and cramped finger stroke strings and keys, filling the air with melodies and resurrected rhapsodies, capture the cadence of ancient chants where shackles are removed and our ancestors dance in anticipation of liberty. And every note that's played is dedicated to their memory. There is a place where each heartache and every sharp pain can be soothed and smoothed by a medicinal refrain. The story of King David makes it plain. And it came to pass that when the evil spirit from God was upon Saul, that David took a harp and played with his hand. So Saul was refreshed and was well, and the evil spirit departed from him. You see, this divinely inspired requiem came forth from a glorious past, and although it defies description, we choose to call it jazz. And ever since this magical music emerged from space and time, it has found a permanent residence on 9+9 and Vine. Okay. Someday soon you'll travel there to escape from cell phones and emails and faxes, from being overworked and underpaid and paying too many taxes. This is the place where even struggle kicks off his shoes and relaxes. And the only war that will ever take place is the battle of the Saxons. This is the place where jazz is served up as a sensual delight, and it smells like grandmother's chitlins because she always cooks them just right. And it tastes like the peach cobbler she bakes that gets better with every bite. And it looks like Susanna Jones when she wears that red dress. Lord, what a beautiful sight. And it feels like love's very first kiss, shared in the soft moonlight. And it sounds like the jazz disciples, cool on a blue Saturday night, or like Gabriel's trump at the rapture, just before we take flight. So these ministers of music are awaiting your arrival, wanting to provide you with orchestral comfort as you witness the revival, because jazz, like matter, can't be destroyed. It only changes forms. And the historic intersection of 18th and Vine is where jazz will be reborn. Then we will cherish this noble noise and glow in the cool of its heat, as the caramel-coated cacophony provides a sonically hypnotic beat that can only ever be heard through the tapping soles of the feet. And as willing slaves to the rhythm, our freedom will be complete. Give it up again for the Jazz Disciples, featuring Chris Clark and Will Matthews.